Okay. So until now we have seen turbines. There were three different kinds of turbines, and how are they working, and what's the purpose of turbine? So we know that the turbines are used to convert a higher head of energy or some stored form of energy inside a fluid into some useful work, that is mechanical output, and generally the mechanical output is converted to an electrical output later. The pumps or hydraulic pumps specifically, they are having exactly opposite purpose and opposite working. Their purpose is to use the electric power, convert to mechanical energy, and then use that mechanical energy to impart energy on the fluid. And we'll be studying hydraulic pumps over here. So hydraulic pumps means the working fluid is water for our case. If not, there could be glycol. There are lot more different kinds of pumps which will handle oils, like oil pump in a diesel pump in our vehicles. But over here we'll check out for only hydraulic pumps. So wherever we are studying hydraulic pumps, the density of fluid is always 1000 kg per meter cube. So it need not be mentioned specifically inside our questions. So I said it's reverse of turbine. So turbine, it uses energy head or head inside the fluid to generate power. Pumps will consume power and increase the stored energy of the fluid. So stored energy can be increase of liquid and either of gas. So pumps are used to, they are all fluid machines. So the fluid can be liquid or gas. So in case of liquid, we increase the energy, stored energy, by increasing the elevation. And because the liquids are assumed to be incompressible, or there are very small changes in density, even though we have very high pressures applied to them. While for gas as the working fluid, that comes in compressors, which videos are also available later. So in the case of gas as the working fluid, we increase the pressure, and that change in pressure is the stored form of energy for the gas. And since gas are compressible. So here we'll look at the liquids. So for liquids, we know that it is an incompressible fluid, and generally this is shown, the configuration or the setup or schematic of a pump is shown like this. This is a pump. This is the suction line. This is the delivery line. Lower reservoir or low elevation reservoir. This is higher reservoir. That is the delivery. So low is the sump. So generally we can see from low reservoir, we have a pump and it goes to higher reservoir. Now coming to the classification of pump. So there are mainly two types of pumps, rotodynamic and positive displacement. In rotodynamic, we can have two types. We will have radial and axial flow. And the purpose or the working in this rotodynamic is we increase the velocity head of the fluid, and this velocity head, that is the dynamic head or the kinetic energy, that's converted to pressure head later by some mechanism. While in positive displacement, they're also called as reciprocating type, there is no change in velocity head. What was the inlet velocity? That is the same outlet velocity. So in radial type, we have centrifugal pump. That means there will be radial inlet and axial inlet and radial outlet. So this is exactly opposite to Francis turbine in terms of construction and working. Working means over there in Francis, we have radial inlet and the fluid was getting axial outlet. Over here in centrifugal pump, we'll have axial inlet and radial outlets. And in axial flow machines, construction and working is opposite to Kaplan turbine. So now let's see the general layout of pumping system. And this is applicable to all types of pumps or pumping systems. So now let's come over here. Let's start from the lower reservoir, that is called as the sump. So this is the sump or lower reservoir, which is at height of HA. And the point outside the pipe is A, and inside it is B. We have a suction pipe, we have a pump, we have a delivery pipe, and we have a higher reservoir, which is generally called as delivery tank. And note down the points A, B. C is the inlet to pump, D is the outlet of pump, E is just before the fluid enters the reservoir, higher reservoir, and F is just inside the reservoir. So F is somewhere over here, E is somewhere over here. And note down, we are saying this is one, this is cross section one, and this is cross section two. This will be helpful when we write Bernoulli's equation. This is Z1, this is Z2. They are the elevation head. HS is the head, and this is the reference datum taken into consideration. Now, this is very important. You can keep this picture in your mind, and things will be very clear to you for solving problems. So suction pipe or suction line is purpose is to suck the fluid inside. So how does it do it? It does by generating a negative gauge pressure. Gauge pressure means relative pressure with respect to atmosphere, and negative pressure means it is lower than the atmosphere. So it is lower than atmosphere, and then in the suction in the sump we have an atmospheric pressure, and over here we have a negative gauge pressure. That means the fluid will be sucked inside this pipe automatically due to the pressure gradient. So P at C, pressure at point C is less than P at M, that is negative pressure head, that is suction end of the pump. C is the suction end, or one, which I showed earlier, this is the suction end, and that is the delivery side. This is the delivery side. And PA is P at M, that is open to atmosphere. HS means difference between lower and higher reservoir, the head, elevation head difference. HA is the head of lower reservoir. HA means inlet head. And HA plus HS is equal to delivery tank head. This you can very easily figure out from the schematic drawn. So head added to fluid by pump is HS. So HS is the static head. That is the net head developed by pump. And change of head across the pump, that is head inlet. Like we'll find out the H2 minus H1. So inlet head H1 is P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1. So this is static pressure, dynamic pressure, and this is due to elevation. So there are three different kinds of head. Similarly, we can write three different kinds of head for outlet side. And head across pump will be H2 minus H1 now. So practically pump is a small device. So this Z2 and Z1 will be very small. This is not to scale image. So Z2 and Z1 will be very close, so we can ignore them. And since objective is to increase the pressure, not velocity, inside the pump, so we can assume V2 is very much equal to V1. So H2 minus H1 is equal to P2 minus P1 by rho g. That is head across pump is P2 minus P1 by rho g. So H2 minus H1 is called as manometric head. And head across pump is equal to change in static pressure, because all other pressures, that is dynamic pressure and elevation change, they are already ignored because of this assumption. So head across pump is only in terms of change in static pressure head across the pump. That is very important. So now let's look at the head terms, head versus time. So this was the inlet. This was just inside the pipe. So this is due to friction. Another loss due to friction is B2C, that is the frictional loss in suction pipe. We come from B to point C. C to D is the pump. So that is the head given by pump. Then when we move from E point is over here. This is the point E. Let me use pen. So this is point E. So this is due to, again, the frictional loss HF2. So HF means the head loss due to friction. HF means head loss due to friction. And this again from E to F. So F is the point at the lower point. So the E to F is due to the expansion, because when fluid is entered from lower cross section to a larger cross section inside the reservoir, there is again a loss that is due to expansion. So that is expansion loss HE. So delta H between point A and B is equal to entrance loss. This is because similarly, when it was going from a lower, smaller pipe to a larger reservoir, from larger reservoir at A, it is entering into a small pipe. That is the entrance loss. HA is equal to H inlet, each H in. HF1 is head loss due to friction. HF1 is HB minus HC. HF2 is again head loss due to friction. That is in the delivery pipe. That will be HD minus HE. HD is higher head, remember. And again, HE is entrance loss due to sudden increase in area in the reservoir. So that is the exit loss. So HE is equal to HE minus HF. So gain in head only between C to D, that is where the pump is given, or that is where we are externally providing any energy to it. And HD is greater than HS plus HA. HS plus HA is the resultant head which we are getting, subtracting the losses. And HD is all the head which is provided by the pump. So this is to accommodate for loss. Then let's come to unit quantities. So unit quantities concept cannot be used between model and prototype. This is very important. And we can be used only for same prototype or same model. So if we have a prototype or a model, we can use the unit quantities concept on the same model. And since D changes, N changes, we are not getting constant. So this may not be related right now, but we'll see when we check the performance characteristic of the pump. But this is to check, remember that where and where not, we can apply the concept. So let's come to here. So we have seen this was the manometric head P2 minus P1 by rho g. HS is the static head gained. This is the net head gain. H is the gross head, which is the total head given by the pump. And H minus HS are the losses which occur due to friction, and entrance loss and exit loss. So friction loss are 2. We have another entrance loss. We have a exit loss. So subtracting these all losses from the net head given, gross head given, we'll have the net head. And there are other losses because of bends. And so hence, the H is the total head provided by the pump is equal to HS. That is the net head, which we'll see as a resultant, plus all the loss. And hence, the loss can be expanded like this. That's all. From next video, we'll look at the centrifugal pump in detail. So till now, we have seen all the introduction to general pumping system. All type of pumps follow this type of modeling for getting the expressions for head and loss or the manometric head. Thank you.